I think GE has been in the wind business for some time, and since GE acquired the energy activity of Alstom back more than 2 years ago, that allowed GE to diversify, I mean, from onshore wind also to offshore wind, and to build a more global presence in onshore. And since that time, we have kept not only maintaining a strong leadership in the US onshore wind market, but developing globally in offshore and developing our global onshore wind presence. So today, more than 60% of the orders we book in wind come from outside the US. And if you just look at 17, we had very significant wins in places like Sweden, Thailand, Australia, Spain. So we are really building a global onshore wind business, investing in technology, more performing, better, cheaper turbine. And that's a movement that will continue in the years to come and will also develop fast in the offshore segment. I think it will continue to go down. I think there is a lot of pressure due to competition with other fuel sources, including primarily solar, that there is many places in the world moving to auction system that continues to drive price down. So the way we are building our plan is to continue the decrease of wind costs, which on one side is a good news for us because it means that wind will continue to be at grid parity against fossil fuels in more and more countries of the world, and wind will continue to have sustained growth. On the other side, it leads us to keep working every year on our cost structures, do cheaper products, more efficient turbines, and kind of compensate this price decrease via better cost and investing in more technology. So I expect that to continue. I mean, we are operating today more than 2 gigawatts of wind farms in Pakistan. We are currently building a project in Oman, which will be the first large-scale turnkey project in that part of the world. We have wind turbines operating in Morocco, and we are looking at many markets, from Morocco to Egypt to Middle East to develop wind. So we are very confident that onshore wind will develop fast in the region in the years to come. We have seen the program from the Saudi government, which is having its first wind tender for a 400 megawatt project. We see projects developing in Jordan. We see the Egypt government coming back with ambition in the wind industry. So there are a lot of momentum for onshore wind across the Middle East region. I think it's a major trend, and I think we are only still scratching the surface of it, I think. When we discussed wind cost coming down, it's not only the cost of the turbine, it's also having the turbine operating better, and also having the cost of doing the operation and the maintenance of the turbine coming down. And that is going to achieve via digital, via software. When you have, like GE, 60 gigawatts of wind operating across the world, you have a mine of data because you have all these turbines producing data at every minute. And if you can turn this data into something that allows us to keep improving the performance, better forecasting the maintenance and the failure of the components, optimizing your maintenance cost, you'll keep improving not only your performance, but the performance of your customer and the cost of wind energy. So I think we at GE have invested a lot in digital. We are working with our customers to have an array of digital solutions, from forecasting weather to cyber security, to condition monitoring of components, to every kind of segments of the operation of a wind farm, and we'll keep investing because we think it's a big part of the future for the wind industry. Today, there are different ways to store renewable energy, which is variable, and means that the more renewable energy penetrates into the grid, they increase the need for storage. First thing today is that hydro has always played and will continue to play a key role in storing renewable energy. There is a natural marriage between hydro and renewable energy. And then we'll move to batteries. And we are invested in GE, looking at batteries technology, trying to figure out what is going to be the right battery technology, because it's clear that battery will become economical, that batteries will gain scale, not only thanks to energy, but thanks also to electrical vehicle. And that's the next disruption ahead for players like us and for our customers.